Thank you for the invitation. My name is Keiko ZAIMA from Kyoto Sangyo University. I will talk about green management CSV and its relationship between SDGs. Before my lecture, let me introduce myself a little. My major was polymer science at graduate at undergraduate, and after graduation, I entered toy industry and engaged in research and develop. Research and development. Some new materials for print, printed board and carbon fiber. And the carbon fiber is popular and is used for example, body of electric vehicle and blades of turbine and so on. And at that time, the story was about 35 years ago. After making a prototype of materials and my testing, those materials were thrown away as industrial waste. So I felt it was too big problem. So and at that time, global warming and global environmental issue was rising awareness. So, and I thought there might exist technology, for example, to separate for such a complicated material to, for example, metals or so. So, but the technology was not used because of taking costs and adding more work. So it was not for variable for the company's activities. I thought that we need some kind of system or a policy for more environmental activities. So I decided to enter graduate school of Kyoto University, and I learned environmental economics and policy. And during the master and doctoral course, I studied also at that time a new technology, new methodology named agent-based modeling and simulation. Because I think traditional environmental theory is not enough to explain some dynamics and changes of society, including sustainability. So I'm now teaching and researching mainly green management. So this and this profile is summarized. My research theme is policy design for sustainable society, and especially I focus on innovation diffusion of green management in SMEs. And the left side figure expresses my triangulation methodology of my research. And I'm doing empirical research, including interview, survey, and case study. And then after, I will do a questionnaire survey and data analysis. And based on the empirical research, and I make model agent-based model and simulation with scenario analysis for some kind of policy design. And these days, I focus on information. Information system, a new methodology. I started to develop a new methodology for information system and gaming simulation. But today only I will talk about only basic issues of green management. So So this is part of my presentation and the first SDGs, CSV and the ESGs, and I will talk about its relationship. Second is overview of green management. And third, if I have time, I will introduce a little about my earlier research. So let's move on to the first topic, SDGs, CSV and ESG. And as you know very well, SDGs are our common goals to be achieved by 2030. So industries and companies are also required to participate into solving activities. So these days, companies, especially large companies, have started to analyze and identify materialities of SDGs to them. So materiality means that the items, the goals are important for the company and should take action. So companies focused some goals and centered them medium or long-term goals for the company. For example, Suntory Holdings identified four goals from SDGs related to them as materialities. So based on them, Suntory started to take action, for example, water stewardship management and greenhouse gas SPTs certification activity. So materiality is related to accountability. So as you know, accountability comes from the relationship between entrusted and entrusting. So shareholders invest the company, so the company should report how the company used the money. So and it's annual, so company should publish annual reports. The annual report is legal disclosure. But when the companies tell the lie in the annual report, or annual report does not have important issue related to the company. So sometimes the stock prices fall down and investors and shareholders will lose money. So materialities from the financial aspect is essential to annual reports. But and in 1989, Exxon Valdez accident happened. It was a big accident by oil tanker, and Exxon company had to pay a lot of money for recovery of ecosystem of Alaska, Alaska Sea. So, and at that time, investors found that there were no information about such environmental risks in the annual report. Even when annual reports have materiality of financial information. So, institutional investors collaborated with environmental NPOs and settled an organization named CERIDS. So CERIDS made principles for company to follow. And these principles include some concepts of environmental management system. So after the events, many companies have started to take action for environmental green management and publish their activities in environmental report or sustainability report. So materiality is also regarded as an important issue in such a sustainable reporting. But sustainable reporting is a voluntary disclosure, but company has responsible to the us and the society. So companies should report their activities. And institutional investors' behaviors have changed since 2006, when United Nations principles for responsible investment was declared. And PRI requires institutional investors to incorporate ESG consideration in their fund managing. So ESG movement was becoming a big wave in financial markets. And evaluation index of corporate has changed since the PRI. So in traditional viewpoints, financial aspects was most important. But these days, ESG information is also important to evaluate the company's activities. Because financial performance, such as profits and ROE also represents present and past performances. But ESG information include potential of future opportunities or risks. So ESG is becoming important. Global companies have started to publish integrated reporting, ESG reports, including both financial and ESG issues. And international organizations have started to discuss and make some rules for integrated reporting. So in near future, I think integrated reporting will become legal disclosure. So, and ESG movement has been expanding, and these days, the amount of ESG investments shares about 30% or more, and it is increasing. So, and there are several types of ESG investments, but if you have a question, I will explain it later. And also, the share and of ESG investment becoming larger, there is some problems. For example, there are a lot of evaluating agency and criteria are different from agency to agency. So it is not easy for investors to compare which one is better also. ESG, so companies, especially large cap global companies, acting for the environment and society, and those activities are divided into three categories: product, process, and social contribution. And those activities are also divided into two categories. One is activities as a good citizenship, activities as a CSR, and the other is activities for creating shared value. So there are several definitions of CSR, corporate social responsibility. You know social responsibility, corporate social responsibility, CSR. And this one is a definition provided by Tanimoto Sensei at Waseda University. So CSR is to incorporate social justice and environmental consciousness into the activity of the corporation to achieve accountability. And CSR is aiming at to improve economic, social, and environmental performance. So CSR focus on the balance of the three three performances. But in traditional view of CSR, CSR, the concept is CSR has a very long history from since 1920. So and these days CSR is focused on related to SDGs. And in traditional view of CSR, CSOs, CEOs and many people regarded CSR as a just contribution to the society as a good corporate citizenship. So Porter and Kramer, they were researcher and practitioners of strategic theory of the company. So they insisted that strategic thinking of CSR is more important. So companies should fit their business to solve some kind of social and environmental issues. So the company can get competitive advantage with harmonized with social issue. So they say they suggested a concept of strategic CSR, but this concept was not diffused. So Porter and Kramer redefined again as a new concept of creating shared value. So the meaning of creating shared value equals strategic CSR. So CSV means to achieve both social goals and financial goals of the companies at the same time through their own business. So, and CSV is easy to understand. So, and many and CEOs accept the concept, and CSV is a basic concept these days in business administration areas. So CSV's concept changed corporate purpose. In traditional view, CSV, in traditional view, companies conduct a business and get sales and profits, and the products will satisfy to the customer, so they can get profits. And from the profit, the company can pay tax, and the tax is a contribution to a society. So it's a simple and traditional corporate purpose. But these days, current view is changed. Corporate purpose is creating shared value. So company can contribute to the society through their own business. So as summarizing the first part of my lecture, I'll explain a relationship between SDGs, CSV, and ESG again. So SDGs are our common goals, so, and companies take identified materialities of SDGs, and they set goals are centered in the company, and they are acting for them. So we can see ESG, environmental and social activities from ESG information. And these days, corporate evaluation has been changed, including both financial and ESG issue. ということで、すいません。この、で、あと、よろしいですか。 And well, let's move on to the second topic, overview of green management. And as you know, SDGs have several environmental issues, and ESGs is environment. But before ESG movement, as you know, companies had been required of green management. There are roughly three historical backgrounds. One is environmental issues have ranged from local issue to international issue, as you know. So multiple policy became necessary from mandate regulation to economic treatment or voluntary approach to promote green management of the company. So the second is a summit and industries also get awareness of environmental issues. And the third is requirements of environmental management system. And after Exxon Valdez accident, environmental management system was required to the companies. So industries required international organization for standardization to make some standards concerning environmental management system. So made ISO 14001, and the certification started in 1996. So, and companies has can have some tool, common tool for environmental management system. So there are recent background, and as I said already, ESG investment and SDGs, and the other ones, large companies are required to manage for all supply chain from the viewpoint of environment sustainability. And the other ethical consumption is becoming large in the market. So, and there are many definitions of green management. So, for example, Hardin provided a comprehensive definition of green management from the literature review of green management. And this definition is mine. It is based on Taniwachi Sensei's CSR definition. And green management is to incorporate environmental consciousness into the full process of corporate activities based on environmental philosophy, and to improve both environmental and financial performances. And there are many definitions, but definitions have common key points. So I picked up three. One is decision making of top management. So green management is very related to decision making of CEOs, including philosophy, strategy, and also. And if CEOs does not decide to do for environment, green management does not start. So the second is green management involves activities of a wide range, corporate wide range from the value chain in the company and the supply chain, including the company from the top and bottom. And the third is green management is aiming at both environmental and economic goals. So, by the way, what is the difference between green management and normal corporate management? And I suggest three points. One is the roles of top management has been changed. And the second is relationship between the company and stakeholders has been redesigned. And third, the meaning of value chain, value creation, and information system, management system is changed. So I will explain a little, each. And this figure shows, illustrates normal top roles of top management. Top management states corporate philosophy, what the company should do and be. And based on the philosophy, top management decide business and strategies and make organization and motivate people for attaining the business. So in green management, so the decision making of top management should be incorporated for green consciousness. So top management's decision making and consciousness is essential for green management. And the second, companies conduct businesses facing four markets. And traditionally, product market is very, is most important. But these days, financial market is becomes important to the company. And the company is in the society, so a company should comply. The regulation and policies of the government and NPOs give requirements to companies. So companies should choose which one to be action. So and these days, as you know, more people faced of the planetary boundary and the environment issue is essential for the company too. So, and as I said already, there are some key points, key words to the company, key words of the important of the company. So, companies should redesign of the relationship between stakeholders and redesign business. As you know, well, these days, top three issues for green management is like this. Climate change, including mitigation and adaptation, and decarbonization is main keywords. And the second is to create circular economy. And the third is natural resource stewardship and biological diversity issue. So, and then this figure shows roughly corporate management process. Companies put managerial resources and output products and services to be satisfied consumers' needs and demands. So companies can get sales and added value from the activities. So normal corporate management focus on the financial activities like this. But as you know, during the normal processes of the company's activities, environmental burdens are related to their activities, using of energy and resources and the emission of waste and pollutants. So through companies act for the environment, some environmental burdens can be reduced, and sometimes they develop some new technology or some new business, so create some new environmental impacts plus positive impacts on the earth. So it can be said such a reduction and generation of environmental impacts means green added value to the society. So in green management, so companies focus on both sides of the activities. And in green management, companies should understand and grasp the types of and kinds or and amounts of environmental burdens. And there are several management tools, and typical six types of tools like this. So environmental management system is a representative tool for the company, for the organization to do action for the environment. The essence is to operation based on PDCA and continuous improvement. PDCA is a plan, do, check, and management review and act to next stage. And before the system, before making a system of PDCA, organization should understand at present conditions. So do and check is important in advance. So establish a system and making rules and do activities and checking them, PDCA. And EMS requires organization to comply regulation and policy, environmental policy relating to the organization. And the other requirement is to pick up voluntary goals to be achieved based on environmental impact assessment. And the EMS requires all participants from bottom top down and from bottom up to bottom up. And the life cycle assessment of products and environmental impact assessment of organization is a different tool, but common key point is input process output analysis. And there are a lot of processes. In each process, the company survey and check the input of the environmental burden and output of the pollutants and waste. So IPO analysis is basis. And then after each process, environmental burden is checked. And after that, total is calculated. But this is a very useful tool, but implementation is a little difficult for companies. So those tools are used only for mainly large companies that tackle with environmental green management. So, but in general, life cycle thinking is important to redesign of the products and services. And also systems level thinking is essential to create a new business model. So I will pick up some examples. So, and Ottoman, who is marketer and marketing researcher, provided 15 points of life cycle thinking to redesign greener products. And I will pick up some. So as you know, there are many products with usage of resources for sustainable management thinking. And there are many greener products. For example, Ikeuchi organic towel is made of 100% of green energy. So, and Toray Industries developed a new technology for purification of recycled polyester. So, Uniqlo First Retailing use such a technology into their wares. So, and many companies are doing for social contribution activities. But these days, plastic recycling is increasing. For example, Lion started to collect used teeth brush from the household and to recycle it to making planter. But this activity is just for social contribution for education at school. So greener based on life cycle thinking is relative. So for example, hybrid vehicle was green products about 10 or 20 years ago, but these days, hybrid vehicle are regarded as a transition to the more greener vehicle. So, and it is said that non-linear innovation is necessary. So, for example, innovating at the systems level change from eco-vehicle to sharing business or so, or creating a new business model and a new market. So, and these days, circular economy is one of the important issues for the company and industry. And it seems that brand new issue, but Rico provided the concept of comet circle in 1994 in earlier stage of their green management activities. So comet circle means inner circle is desirable for the environment. So the comet circle is one of models for circular economy provided by Ellen MacArthur Foundation. And Rico started the business of reconditioning copiers and customer to customer model. And another example, Teijin developed technology of chemical recycling. And Patagonia used the technology for their wear. And they create circle business. So Patagonia and post used wear, Patagonia collected and Teijin chemical recycling to recover material. Raw materials. So, and they expanded this circular worldwide. But Teijin's factories was in China. So, as you know, about 3 years ago, China stopped import of waste according to Basel Convention. So, this circle activity stopped. So there is a policy change risk. And これはいいかな。There is another example and small and safe electric vehicle with fabric body. But this project was stopped because of there are many obstacles. For such a tiny vehicle to be driven in the normal road. So they stopped. So many obstacles, so feasibility is difficult for them. And Nippon Polygon is a very small company, but they developed new products and new markets to developing companies. They developed a purified water agent from natto, neba neba, polyglutamic acid, and they sell in the area where people cannot access clean water. So they make a system to door-to-door delivery by ladies, and they employ ladies, polyglot lady, so people can drink it. And Nippon Polyglot also developed small plants of water purification and polyglot supported to management of them. ということで、ちょっと脱線しすぎました。To be, I talk too much. So, talking back to the green management. So, green management activities have two axes. One is compliance, and the other is voluntary. And activities are divided in roughly three categories: product, process, and social contribution. And there are four opportunities for the company to improve both environmental and economic performances. One is cost area. Cost area means companies reduce environmental burdens and treatment or usage of raw materials is reducing. So the cost to expense them will be reduced. So it's cost area and basic activities in green management. And the second is risk management. So the company should find and manage risks before those risks are happened. So for example, Teijin's technology cannot be used these days because of policy shock. So so consideration risk management is important. And these days, big disease big accident and disease would be caused by green or climate change or so. So those risks should be considered in green management. And the third is revenue area through green products and green business. And testing and Winston provide some keywords for green business. And the fourth is intangible area. Intangibles created, for example, green brand can be created according to accumulation of many environmental activities and as well as social contribution activities. So it's very difficult to be construct. And this figure is based on ST and Winston's Green to Gold. They are not an academic researcher, but also they are practitioners and consultants. So and their book is easy to read, and Green to Gold includes overview of green management, essence of green management. So it's I think it's useful for researchers too. So as summarizing this part, so many companies started to activities for the environment and for the and as a citizenship and also creating social value. So ということで、どうしましょう。まだ
短め。
はい、すみません、長くなっちゃって。So, in the third part, I will introduce a part of my research, green management in small and medium-sized enterprises. So, small and medium enterprises definitions are different country by countries, but most of them are defined according to employees number. So in Japan, manufacturing industries, SMEs are defined as companies whose employees are less than 300 or so. And the more than 90% of country companies are SMEs, and their impact on the economic aspect is large. And there is not an accurate estimation of environmental aspects of caused by SMEs. But its aggregations of environmental impacts seems to become large. But SMEs does not take green management not enough. So promotion of SMEs green management is one of significant issues, policy issues for the society. And so, ちょっとまあこれも省きまして、there is a, so, and, for example, EMS certification is not enough spreaded in the society. And like, and there are six categories of empirical research of green management in SMEs. One is to analyze strategic types, for example, proactive or reactive. And the second is to clarify internal and external factors to promote green management of SMEs. The third is to analyze the relationship between performance of environmental and financial. And the fourth is to design policy and support to SMEs. And the fifth is to develop a new tools, for example, easier using of EMS or so. So this figure illustrates the summarize of empirical research. And around 2000, business partners of SMEs started to require green action to SMEs. There are roughly three factors. One is requirement of environment management system, international standards, that ISO. And the second is related to tightening of chemical substances. And the third is at present level of management of green supply chains requirement to the large company. So, and in my early stage of research, I focused on upper two factors, and I wanted to analyze how and what to extent such a requirement affects SMEs activities. So I made questionnaire survey, and there are many points of survey items, and まあ、この辺はいいかな。So, requirements from business partners are divided into EMS and chemical substances activity management. And items of green activities are divided into process and product and society, social activities, and cost, risk, revenue, intangibles. But it was earlier stage. For green management of SMEs. So I focused most on process activities. And I synthesized a comprehensive index of environmental activities. And this is one result of covariance structure analysis. So we found that there are two passes to improve environmental performance of the SMEs. One path is when SMEs are subcontracted type, supplier types business, and when SMEs face with severe condition of market. According to green requirement to the SMEs, SMEs can improve economic environmental performance. And the other case is SMEs have much advantage of high quality, low cost or sales force have. And based on the financial performance, environmental such SMEs can improve environmental performance. And in both cases, knowledge acquisition concerning, for example, EMS or for regulation policy information is important. And support, informational support is essential to the activities. And also environmental awareness of CEO was important. So, After the questionnaire survey, I interviewed again some cases of SMEs who acquired high scores of environmental activities. So they started from the base of EMS activities and according to support of business partner. And after that, they get know-how and they improve by their own. So, and as for SME requirement from business partner is conditions, important conditions for SMEs to going concern. So SMEs should obey such a requirement. But SMEs can get support from the business partner and sometimes government, and they can do environmental activities. And after that, SMEs can get merit from the financing. So bank, from the bank, when SMEs want to borrow money from the bank. So, and I researched of roles of information support based on this knowledge from empirical research and agent-based simulation is done. So, if you want to please read my paper. And after the earlier research, I stepped up several empirical researches. And these days, I started another research for creating a new methodology of environmental information. And a brand new research theme is gaming simulation to understand green management. So, So this is finish of my talk. So very first talk. Do you have what comments and questions do you have?
Okay, Zaima-sensei, thank you very much.